Hi folks, this is a very quick but very important video because I just got done or in the process of actually still grading papers and grading discussion boards, and the papers are fabulous. I did have one student who's not going to be able to submit the paper on time. He let me know, he let me the reason why, and of course, you know, I'm flexible enough that the person's going to get the paper on time within the time frame that we discussed. So this video is all about timeliness. I'm very concerned, actually, because as you know, if you have had me before, and I know a lot of you have, I'm probably one of the fairest and most concerned instructors that you'll find. And that's not a kudos for me. That's because that is who I am. So as I was grading the discussion boards, and some of them I've already graded. I graded them one day ago, 2 days ago, because the amount of responses were in, the quality of responses were in, and the timeliness of the responses were in. Now I'm going to explain just a little bit to you if you have never taken any UNE courses before, too. Our discussion board rubric has changed. We had one. I think it was working, but in some of the online courses, because the College of Graduate Professional Studies now has all the underlying online courses under their umbrella, and there must have been students who just weren't getting their responses in, either on time or the quality wasn't good. So they came up with a rubric that was across the board on all online programs the same, which makes sense, of course. You want to standardize something so students are seeing different rubrics. So all the rubrics are the same now in all of the courses, including ours. So if you think the rubric is the same as what it was, it's not. And if you haven't looked at the rubric yet, please do. Because when students don't email me at cmarcott@une.edu to let me know they might be late, there's a reason why they might be late, I can take that upon myself to give flexibility. When people don't let me know, I have to give zeros now in discussion board. I don't want to do that. I'm here for students. I'm here to support students. So I'm going to look over to my right for a moment, and I'm going to review with you, and please look at it too if you're one of the people that didn't get full credit for the discussion board this week. If you did get full credit, then you were on time, etc., etc. There's two components now to the discussion board, and what they are is timeliness. So if you don't get that initial response in, that substantive response in on Wednesday, then you get 0 points. I can't work around that. So incomplete initial response is not posted by the due date. I have no choice. So then I'm going to look down into content. That's the second part. In content, it says 0 points. Student does not complete the assignment. No points will be given for this criteria if points to classmates are made past the due date. So if you don't do anything, obviously you get 0 points. But if you go all the way down to that part of the rubric, the last line says, and I reread it and reread it today, no points will be given for this criteria if posts to classmates are made past the due date. I had someone who posted 3 responses this week, late in the week. The first one was a phenomenal substantive response. The other 2 engaged dialogues, which we used to call them in the old rubric, were great too. 3 great postings of responses, all late. I had to give 0 points. I had no choice. So I'm sending this to you in your UNE email. When I get the video done, I'm actually going to try to register it. I'm not going to do closed caption. Because it's important for me to have you know. I want you to get it like ASAP. So that's why I'm doing it this way. So please allow me to give you the points that you deserve. Okay, thank you so much for listening to this video. And if if you're late, you're going to be late, let me know. I'm very understanding. You all have lives and jobs and everything else. So you're doing double duty right now, and I want to work with that. Okay, thank you. Have a great day and a great week, and I look forward on your discussion boards. I'm sorry to the my informal attire. There's no classes on, well, there's online classes, but there's no face-to-face classes here. So people in the office are minimal. Okay, thank you so much. Thank you.